DJ Ace.
Yo, what's up, YouTube? This your boy DJ Ace from DJ Ace Productions, Regional Sound Solutions, back at you again. Your boy is back out in the lab, out in the garage, doing a product review on some new speakers, a new speaker line that I just picked up. I have been contemplating on picking me up another power system for my small to medium-sized mobile rigs, and I was hard-pressed between a few lines, whatever. I had did my product research, went online, did some reviews, and actually went to a couple stores and listened to them and everything, and I had made a final decision on the ones I want. I looked at the ETXs by EV, the JBL, the SRXs, and stuff like that, and they were very impressive and everything, but one of the lines I had ended up going with was the... Ta-da! Your boy ended up going with the RCF line, so I ended up investing in the RCF, the HD35As, and the Sub-8003s. So I'm getting ready to do a product unboxing and review and everything. I'm gonna fire them up just to get an idea of what they look like and what they sound like. Sorry about that. And demo them a little bit for myself. I got a gig this weekend for a wedding that I'm eager to use them on. So let me turn this around. I got this gimbal camera for my phone. That I'm eager to use them on, so I'm ready to unbox them, hook them up, and review them here. I just got them yesterday. They were all delivered together. Even got the caster kits for the sub, which I ordered off eBay. It was a lot cheaper. So if you're looking for PenFab casters, you can go to SoundPal on eBay, well, US Bargain, Pro Speakers Parts, and order them through there. I am no way getting paid to endorse RCF products, but I do like their products. One of my sound partners had invested in some RCF subs, and wow, those things are amazing. Shout out to Stewart Production, who uses RCF in his rig, and man, them things, the RCF put a good rig together. Not to say that the other domestic brands is not as good, but I was impressed with them, and I went and looked at them to listen to them for myself, and I was like, I got to have them. So I'm getting ready to set this down, then I'm gonna fire up the video, then I'm gonna unbox them and everything and hook them up and stuff. So check back with you, give me a sec. Yeah, sorry about that. Yeah, it's a little warm out today. Happy 4th of July to everybody. But basically what I got is the two tops, two bottoms, RCF HD35As, and the two sub 8003 AS2s. I have another pair on order. They haven't arrived yet. Subs, that is. I want to get me four subs, and then I'll eventually get me two more tops later on. Sorry about that. I'm trying to learn how to work this smooth, but some of the features I liked about this was the... Sorry about that. As I was mentioning before, the sub gimbal went on his little fritz or whatever. Got the HD35As. One of the reasons I liked, one of the features I liked about this was the fact that it had PowerCon ins and outs. So I wanted to move PowerCon, get away from the IEC cables. And this has the full processing and everything in it. I like this cabinet. The cabinet is pretty light. The neodymium woofers and some of the features that I read with it on the RCF website. So I'm going to go ahead and hook these up, power them up in a bit, and then see how they sound on my own. Not just gonna play any music. I'm gonna play some jazz, some rap, and a little bit some house and some techno. So just to give it a full range to see how it sounds anyway. But give me 1 second. I'm gonna hook everything up, get it going and fire these speakers up. All right, let's take a back look at the back of the sub. You know, you got a bunch of different functions on it and everything. One thing I did notice is that there's no power switch. So when you put this, plug this power con in, it pretty much fires right on up. You can see this little LED, green LED comes on, and then you can start messing with the signal and everything. You can hear the amp delay come on and everything. And it's got some few presets that I'm gonna have to do some reading up on. And it's got high pass and low pass settings and stuff like that. Gives you what the frequency hertz everything is in, and has the inputs and outputs and everything. So I'm gonna read up on this later on tonight and look at a few more YouTube videos of my own. But it's got the stereo crossover link between the sub and the top, so that's pretty much what I did. I just put the crossover link, and I just got the settings set at the factory settings as is. And then I'm gonna go ahead and look at everything. But it has L1, L2, L3 extended low everything. So I'm gonna change a few little settings and crossover points to where I want, maybe 40 to 100 hertz. That's all I need. So I'll probably set it to like H3 or something like that. Cause I ain't trying to. Okay, the L's for the cardioid. So I'm not running no cardioids right now because I'm only running a pair of them. So when I get the other pair, then I cardioid them. But other than that, go ahead. I'm still hooking up the cables and stuff. Fire it up and play something off my phone or maybe my iPod or something like that. Not gonna do a full DJ rig. Man, it's hot today. 4th of July ain't no joke. You know? We wanted nice weather, so it's here, so I'm not gonna complain, but a little sweat ain't never hurt nobody. Man, it's hot. But all right, people, give me one sec. We'll finish hooking up all the cables, then I'll come back and check everything. Switch the camera on. Just hooked up my rusty, trusty ceremony mixer just to get a signal. iPod with a house track on it. Top sound crystal clear. I love it. I don't, can't really tell by this cell phone mic, but I got an iRig mic on it, so it should be pretty clear. You know how I feel. Blossom on the tree. You know how I feel. It's a new dawn. It's a new day. It's a new life. But and I'm sweating like crazy. Sorry about that. But working with setting these gains on the sub, so. Got it like 30 below. Said about 20 and it was sounding really good. Top sound real crystal clear. In the sky, you know how I feel. That's how the cabinet look like. Sound good. So. Sound good. Yeah, it sound real good. I'm really impressed. Yeah, these subs. And the overhead is crazy. Crazy overhead. I mean, they not even breathing. I pumped them up a little bit just to put some thunder in them, but can't wait to demo them this weekend. I got a wedding to do. Probably ain't gonna need, but I can use one, but I'm gonna bring both. I wanna hear how good they really sound. But play one more track, some jazz or something like that, and get it going. And I'm gonna wrap this up. So wrap it up with this right here. So, yeah. I wanted to hear how crystal clear these tops sound. There you have it, HD35 A-Tops and the RCF Sub 8003 AS2s, neodymium drivers in there. I'm eager to pull these woofers out because I want to see what type of woofers they got in there. But they sound really, really good. The box is tuned good. The bass is deep. It's tight. No matter what I played, it was really, really good. So, this is your boy DJ Ace signing out on this product unboxing and review. Hey, don't forget to like, subscribe to my page. Follow me on my, check out my website, djaceproductions.com. Also, follow me on Instagram and Twitter at DJ Ace Productions. And like that, your boy is out. Peace.